Yes, indeed. Welcome to Off the Bench for another week where we celebrate the lifeblood of Australian rules footy, and that is country footy. Sam Hargrave joined by the 97 Kaji Greaves medalist, Liam Pickering. Hello, Picks.
Good to be here, Sammy, and looking forward to another week. Finals around the corner and starting pretty much everywhere in country footy.
It's an exciting time in country footy as well. They get a little bit of clear air so they can play their games without having to compete against the big leagues.
Except the AFL have stuck a game on.
Except for that.
Oh, in a couple of weeks' time, but not this weekend. What's our set this week?
Well, this is very exciting. 32 kilometres west of Swan Hill, you will find the Ultima Recreation Reserve. Now, these guys had some powerhouse years through the Swan Hill District Footy League. They're in the Golden Rivers at the moment, up in the Highlands. But unfortunately, it hasn't been a great year for the Ultima Footy League, footy team. They only two wins this year, but a magnificent setup that they've got there. They got a government grant, Pickers, which meant they got water. They were able to improve their facilities, which meant they were able to stay in the competition. So, fantastic.
Excellent. Excellent to see. Nice looking oval.
Speaking of country footy grounds that we've highlighted before, I want to take you back to a couple of weeks ago. Now, this is where you and Julian
DeStooper
were talking about the Omeo Recreation Reserve. Yeah. Now, the grand final of the Omeo District Footy League is this weekend between Lindenau South Seniors, who finished first, and Swifts Creek Seniors, which finished second. This is what they are going to be coming up against.
Whoa. Is that snow?
That is.
That's going to make it tricky for the footy skills,
that
I would have thought.
It looks like Christmas in Minnesota.
Yeah, it's going to be hard. They're going to have to get the big rake out.
What boots do you wear? We know about the screw-ins and the moulders.
Well, maybe some ski boots. I'm not sure. But
what about those big snow boots that you can wear?
Oh, maybe. It's very... that's going to make it difficult for the skill level of the game, I would have thought. But anyway, a bit of fun. That's the country we live in, isn't it?
Good luck to Lindenau and Swifts Creek. I think you're going to need it in those conditions. That's a long sleeve jumper kind of day. Although Clarko would have been out there with the singlet off. Let's get into the country footy roundup. All thanks to APCO. The new Mexican Jaffle is only at APCO Cafe 24/7. Pickers, let's start with the Gippsland Footy League. Results from the round. Lee and Gatha finish undefeated for the year. Have a look at that. A walloping of Druin, Daisy Thomas territory.
Yeah, absolutely. They've been the team to beat, and they look like a very difficult team to handle in the finals. Morwell, well, they got in by 8 points. Tarolga and Maffra just kicking a lot of points. The Gulls had a win.
So Morwell had to win that, Pickers, to give themselves a chance of finishing in the five, and then they had to hope that Maffra weren't able to beat Tarolga, which wasn't able to occur. So they got in on percentage in the end. Morwell with the 10. They got in on a win, one win over Maffra. If Maffra had a one, they would have gone in on percentage. So pretty tight to finish out the season.
Anyway, you're looking at it, it looks the Langathers to lose, doesn't it? 18 and zip they are for the season. And six games clear of second spot, equal second really, it's one thaggy in sale. So, they look the same to beat.
Jed Lamb, by the way, former Swan, Giant, and Blue, kicked 5 goals to finish with 70 for the year. So, congratulations. This is how the finals are going to shape up. Lee and Gatha are going to play the winner of 2v3, one Thaggy and Sale, but they get a double chance as well. And then Tarolga and Morwell in the elimination final.
Okay, yeah, well, as I said, they'll be sitting back looking the Parrots this week, going, bring it on, boys. We've shown you that we're six games better than you. So, that's what it sits like. Doesn't mean much in finals, as we get to the Ballarat Footy League.
Yeah, so Darley had a good win, 18 points over North Ballarat, who finished the season in sixth position. Ryan Carter for Melton in that massive win over Lake Wendouree, that was first v 11th, so top of the table versus bottom. He kicked 10, 56 for the year, Pickers. The one to take a note of is Sebastopol and Ballarat. So Sebastopol kicked 9-15 to 11-6. If they won that game, they would have secured themselves a double chance.
Yeah, I know. If you only have to look at the ladder, and when you're looking at the ladder, you'll see that we talk about eight-point games, as we see the last game there, eight-point games. So if they go in on the same, basically, Ballarat lose and Sebastopol win, they get the home game.
They do.
So and you kick badly, Sammy, look at the percentage. They've got a 10%, basically
absolutely.
10% better off.
Well, we saw Carlton against Collingwood, bad kicking's bad footy, and they weren't able to secure that double chance, and Redan just missing out on percentage. So as we have a look at the finals and...
The Lakers had a tough year.
That's a tough
one. Lakers, unfortunately. Okay, let's have a look. Melton and Ballarat, first versus second in the qualifying. Now, all the way down to Darley taking on East Point in the eliminations two, and obviously Sebastian and North Ballarat. So You'd think Melton would probably be winning that, wouldn't you?
Yeah, they only lost two games for the year, Melton.
A pretty good team.
Had a very, very good season. Our country footy roundups, all thanks to APCO, the all-new Mexican Jaffel, packed full of Tex-Mex flavours, hot and fresh at APCO 24-7. You do not want to miss out on that. Tom, for one of our favourite segments of the week, country, great country goals.
Yes, we're going to start in the Ballarat Football League as well. And a bit of a mud in the middle of the ground there, but this is Jack Parenti, who gets the ball here beautifully. One-on-one contest coming up and just runs to 50 and just goes whack.
Got to back yourself, Picks. Tucked it under his arm, backed himself.
Well, beautiful finish, but good contest from the big fella. That's an R forward and then a lovely finish on the run. So that's a beautiful goal there. Another one from the Ballarat Footy League is our next, which is Paddy Simpson, who plays, obviously, in this competition. It's Ballarat Footy Club.
Look at the link-up handball here.
Yeah, the Swans. They're the Swans. So that's where, that's where Isaac was. But this is a good team goal, really, when you look at it. And a nice finish, because he really followed his work. And a good snap and not bad commentary. As we have a look at this again. Good, as I said, team goal. They linked up, didn't they? Yeah. And handball over the top.
My grandfather's a life member, was when he was alive. He played about 300 games for Ballarat.
For the Swans?
Yeah.
Okay, very good. A nice finish, Paddy, and good running. Deserved it. And this is Dahlia North Ballarat. And have a look at big Dylan Lant gets in on the end of this one. And a little bit of a banana, I think you'll find. Beautiful finish.
Nice bit of commentary, too.
It was. The ruckman knocks the ball to a bit of space, but the speed runs on and on the left boot. Yeah, beautiful finish. Well done. Three good goals there, actually.
Country Town Spotlight this week after some cracking goals in the great country goals. We're going to shine a light on the Echuca.
On Echuca. It's a beautiful town. It really is.
Marvellous part of the world.
Just over 15,000 people live in the town. They've had some terrific footballers over the years. Ollie Wines, of course, the current Brownlow medalist, the reigning Brownlow medalist and the current star of the AFL. Clayton Oliver, another star of the AFL, the favourite for the Brownlow this year.
Mick Brawn won a premiership with the Eagles.
Mick Brawn, Paul Brown, old teammate of mine. So there's a lot from there, although he's from... Yep. Brownie's from Maroochydore.
Of course, a lot of those guys go down and play in the Bendigo Pioneers in their under-18 competition.
They do.
So we get to know a lot of those guys very well.
Is there a week we go that you don't bring up the Bendigo Football League? You know, Jack Ginnivan's going to get another run in a second. It's unbelievable. Every week we do a whole... Every time you're on this show, we talk about Bendigo. There was no link to Bendigo then.
Bendigo Pioneers under-18 players.
The town was a Echuca, not Bendigo. You've had your go at Bendigo, OK? We know you've got a few mates that watch on from Bendigo. Yes, we get it, Sammy. But come on, mate. Every week? It's too much.
I can't help it that the tentacles of Bendigo footy stretch out to all parts of the country footy globe. Hey, we're off and running to a very nice start. That's on off the bench.
Sickening.
Be back with plenty more, including this week's Who Am I? You do not want to
probably
miss
probably from
week's.
Bendigo.
Welcome back to Off The Bench. Great to have your company. The Who Am I coming up very soon. We're going to induct three new country footy stars into the team of the 2000s. But Pickers first, Bush to the big time. And a couple of crackers this week as well. And I promise you I didn't do this.
Yeah, you did do it.
I didn't do it.
The first player we're going to have a look at is Flynn Perez, who plays for North Melbourne. So he's going to have a new coach, Alistair Clarkson. He was pretty good on the weekend too. Probably one of his better games, to be honest. He had 24 disposals, sorry. And guess where he's from? The Bendigo Football League. What a surprise.
Yeah, played for the Sandhurst Footy Club.
Sandhurst Footy Club. Who are you call? What do you call them?
Well, they're called, in the not to be offensive, but they're called the Slagheads by the rest of the competition.
Well, that sounds a bit rude.
Well, that's just their nickname.
But he's a player that I think will thrive under Alistair Clarkson, Flynn. I think he's a nice player. And
good ball user.
Yeah, he is. He is.
By the way, his old man's got the Rifle Brigade Hotel across from the QEO. If you ever are going to Bendigo, just stop in there for one off the wood. It's a very, very good establishment.
Oh, well, there you go. Look at Sammy trying to get home and get a free beer. Well done to you. The other player we're going to look at is Jermaine Jones, who has made a bit of a career for him. He was very good against Geelong on the weekend. He was originally played for the Cats, North Ballarat Rebels, Broken Hill, raised in Mildura, then moved to Geelong.
Fantastic story too, if you get the chance to look into Jermaine Jones a bit more. It's an incredible journey that he's been on to get to where he is.
Yeah, I was watching him on the game on the weekend, obviously watching the Cats, but he was a guy that couldn't really get a look in at the Cats and went across to the West Coast, and he's had clearly his best season this year.
Yeah, redeployed him as a defender and he's relishing the role.
Yeah, I agree. I think playing off that half-back line...
Look at this.
Half-back line.
Watch the movement here.
His running ball use is very, very good and he was important, especially early in the game when they were doing this sort of stuff to the Cats, but before the Cats got rolling in the second half. But, yeah, no, they're both good stories. I mean, they're not high draft picks. They're guys that have had to fight a bit for their careers, so good luck to both Flynn and Jermaine.
Absolutely. Hey, time for the Who Am I? Let's roll the first clue for this week. See if you can get it first cap off the rank, as you have been doing.
Already originally played for Golden Squad.
I had nothing to do with it.
No, I'll tell you what, you've been on this show 5 minutes and you're already getting the Who Am I's.
I did. Oh,
Golden Square in Bendigo. Okay. No, I can't get it off the silhouette. So we might have to have a break and come back, and when we come back, have another break. No, not really. No, when we come back, well, you have to give me a couple more clues. I'm not getting it off that. A
couple more clues for the Who Am I, and it's a Who Am I that's very close to Liam Pickering's heart. We will reveal it all after this on Off The Bench. Thanks for being with us off the bench. Sam Hargraves, Liam Pickering with you. Before the break, Pickers, we gave you the first clue in this week's Who Am I?
Yep.
You weren't able to jag it, Lock. You have been able to do so often with the first up clue, but let's just revisit that.
No, it's a little bit difficult off that clue, but all right. Golden Square, played for Bendigo, played for 3 VFL AFL clubs. I'm starting to think it might be Diesel, but go on. Incredible, yeah. This is Greg Williams written all over. It doesn't look like much like his silhouette, though. Why is he a man close to my heart?
We'll get to that.
Okay. Incredible handballer, but he was a brilliant footballer. He seriously was. It's Greg Williams, I know that. 2 clubs, teams of the century, yes, that's Diesel for sure. He was a fantastic, 2-time Brownlow medalist.
Almost 3 times.
Should have probably been 3 times.
Should have been 3.
And won the Norm Smith deal, did he ever, in 1995. He gave us a nice old touch-up. In that game in 1995. So there he is. I knew he was... Yep. So he got to 250 games.
Greatest player ever out of Bendigo still for mine. The 2 Brownlows premierships as well. I mean, he did it all, didn't he, in his career. 2 All-Australians is baffling to me.
Yeah, how come he only won 2 All-Australians? Oh, that's why you've got...
Now, he considered untaggable until this day. Semi-final, 1994.
You show a lot of me running over the top of him. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, this was a great mark. I remember that.
Geelong missing several of their starting on ballers. They turned to a man to do a job, and that man is sitting to my left. Pickers, talk us through this day, please.
Well, we had a number of good players out of action that day.
Here we go. And a bounce. And a 50.
Yeah, and there you go. I was looking for it. It was a pass. we had a lot of our good players not playing. So Couch, Bairstow, Hocking were all out. Michael Mansfield, who was all Australian that year, was out as well. And so they threw the magnets around and landed on me to play on the little diesel.
That goal for Gary Ablett was clutch, and you guys getting that win, by the way, too, in that semi-final. But it's one thing to ask you now about how you felt about the tagging job you did on Diesel that day. But let's hear from you then.
Oh, no, not with his voice.
Gary's been the captain. And there's Gipper down there with Pickering. Played a marvellous game for Geelong. So did his opponent, Greg Williams. They were both superb today.
Well, Liam, first of all, congratulations on a great personal game, but also on a great team effort.
Yeah, thanks very much. Yeah, it was great. We came out here today, we thought with the 3 out that they, to throw them out, and we thought if we all stuck together and had a fair can go, we'll get there.
Well, tell your supporters, when did you find out that you were going to have the tough job?
Not till last night. I think originally Kiatchi was going to have it, and I'm missing the celebrations here. Kiatchi was going to have it, but then he was injured, so...
Could have been a blessing because you hadn't had too long to think about it.
Well, that was it, yeah. He said to me last night, go to bed and dream about him, so I dreamt about him.
This is embarrassing.
Were you on helium that day?
That's bad.
What's happening
That's
with your bad. Voice?
Oh, I don't know. I was young. I was younger. I've aged a lot since then. That was not in 1994. So we're talking, 28 years ago. So
been a bit happened since then.
The
That was a great game. The prelim against North Melbourne was one of the all timers.
In that final series, we'd beaten Bulldogs in the first final after the siren.
Yep.
Beat Carlton, who were the premiership favourites, about 4 goals in the finish, I think it was, who no one expected us to beat them with the team we had, and then beat North Melbourne in the prelim after the grand final.
Is that when Mick
after
Martin...
the, sorry, after the final siren, and then we went into the grand final and West Coast gave us a touch-up.
Is that when Mick Martin kept Gary Ablett goalless all game until the last?
He kicked a couple.
I thought it was that wasn't the day.
No, he wasn't goalless, but he got a couple early. But No, he did a great job on Gary, yeah. And Gary took a mark as the siren went with the scores level.
Yeah.
From the top of the goal square, which was the following week from that game.
It was an epic final series for Geelong. Unfortunately, it didn't end in the ultimate, but it was just a brilliant run to get there against the odds. Let's get into our team of the 2000s.
Okay, we're starting off. We have got the team coming there magnificently. We just want to finish off our starting 18. So we will start off firstly with a forward pocket. And it's the man from Wodonga, the big G-Train.
Oh, yes.
Who's a fantastic player. Gee, we've got some fearsome players in our full forward line. Fraser Gehrig and Barry Hall next to each other.
It's a very intimidating forward setup.
It is. Look at his numbers, though.
That's the career.
Started at the West Coast as a wingman, if you can believe it. A big, quick, tough wingman. And then went to the Saints and became a really strong key forward. Two-time All-Australian, a couple of Colemans. Kicked 100, remember. We'll talk about that as well. Six-time leading goal kick. And a good bloke. Got a lot of time for Fraser. He's a fantastic fella.
Remember this? This is the prelim in 2004 against Port Adelaide when he kicked two in a row, the second of which I think was the 100th.
Yeah, well, and this is what happened though. St Kilda started off really well. And then when he got his 100th, the crowd came on and sucked a bit of momentum out of it. It took him about 5 or 6 minutes to get the crowd off the ground. And the worst part, the funniest thing about that story was, here they all come. One of the guys on the ground was Stephen Baker's dad.
Yep, just having a chat with the players.
Having a chat to the players, like, off you go, son. Poor Fraser had to go off the ground.
They take him off.
I've seen him bigger, yeah. It was a great game, this.
Phenomenal game of footy.
And then
Port got away from him, then St Kilda pegged him back. And do you remember the final moments? Do you remember the final moment, the Gavin Wanganeen snap from the boundary from 45 metres and then Brent Guerrero running into the open goals, yeah. Sean Burgoyne in the lunge to dispossess him?
They were destined to win that flag, Port Adelaide. They'd been the best team in the comp for a few years. Look at the pace of the big fella, though. He's running away from, look at Dean Solomon then. Okay, so we got there. Jimmy Bartel goes in. The Brownlow medalist, the champ from the Cats. Jimmy Bartel into the guts, which I like a lot. That midfield's shaping up magnificently. At the moment, have a look at his numbers. So Brownlow medalist, 3 premierships. Obviously the Norm Smith in 2011, a couple of Australians. Didn't win a best and fairest, which is surprising given he won a Brownlow.
Yeah.
But Gary.
There's a fair few around.
He won that by 100 votes, Gary, the best and fairest in his Brownlow.
I think there's only one other player in the competition that's played over 300 games, won 3 premierships, and has a Norm Smith and a Brownlow, and that's Simon Black. So it's not a massive catch-up that they have when that club gets together.
Just a couple of them. But, yeah, what a fantastic footballer Jimmy Bartel was and stood up in big games.
Best wet weather player I reckon I've seen.
Yeah, everyone seems to think he was a great wet weather player, but he was a fantastic dry weather player too,
yep.
Jimmy. And what a superstar. And stick him in the middle. We're pretty happy with that midfield that we've got there. And here he is in the grand final. Just coming around the corner and banging one home. And that was his Norm Smith against the Pies.
Unflappable in big moments, wasn't he?
He was. He won the game after...
Was he underrated, Picks?
Oh, I don't think he was underrated by anybody, to be honest, Sam. Anyone that knew, that followed the Cats closely, loved him. And I think every other club would like to have had him.
Yeah.
So I think that means you're not underrated. But he was just a class player.
Yeah.
And he's a bit bigger than you'd expect. He didn't look big, but he was a beautiful overhead mark. So,
well, speaking of marks, have a look at this one.
Look at the courage of him. Just a freak.
Yep.
But, he was a great mark. And I remember him as a junior. Professional, really. Just a pro and 300 games. All that beer did a bit. Remember?
This was to beat Hawthorn, that point to continue the Kennett curse.
Yeah, well, that's what happens. President opens up his big gob. The Cats win 13 in a row. That's what happens against you blokes. And in the back pocket, David Wirrpanda, who's from Healesville, who is he was a class player. Started off as a forward, played a bit on the wing. Found his niche really as a defender in the finish. He started as a defender and found his niche as a forward at the back end of his career. Premiership player, of course, from Healesville Footy Club, and does great things over in the West. Wirra, fantastic man. And, he was a beautiful player. He's one of those real smooth movers, wasn't he?
Yeah, you just got captivated by watching him. He's one of those players that made footy look easy. If you were going to show people the game, you'd say, well, just watch this guy do it, because he just made it look effortless.
Yeah, he certainly did, and played in those 2 grand finals, obviously. And they won one and lost one. And this is the one they won against the Swans. They were just 2 great games. I loved them both, to be honest. The West Coast in 2006 premiers, and Wirra played a very, very good role in that as well. So... yeah, I'm pretty happy with the starting 18 we've got in this team so far. There he is with Drew Banfield, a man of few words, Drew. Certainly when he was on the boundary line for Fox Footy, he was a man of few words. I know that. great person. And there is Wirra there doing what he does. Beautiful skills. Daniel Kerr, obviously across to his mate.
Have a look at this. In full flight.
Wirra.
Oh, Candy Commerce, not once but twice.
Look at the class mover. Look at the movement of him. Just a beautiful football.
Did notice the ability to, like, you thought he was at full pace.
And then he went
and
again.
And then when he was confronted, he had another gear.
Well, that's what the real top liners have. They've got gears and, you know, you saw it. That was a perfect example of what he actually could do, cutting through traffic. He was a super player. So we're really only a bench away now from having our team compiled.
That team would be almost impossible to beat, I reckon, and can't wait to see who gets in. On the bench after this, on Off the Bench, our handshake hero, and also the clash of the week to finish up. Almost time for us to say goodbye and Off the Bench, but not before we get into our country clash of the week. And Pickers, where are we heading?
Ballarat Football League, and we talked about it earlier. It's the top versus second, so Melton and Ballarat. It's going to be a good game, that one. Melton looked the best team in the comp, but finals spit up some different opportunities for clubs to cause upsets, as we know.
Yeah, just two losses for the year for Melton. Ballarat, I think, had the four. Be pretty tightly held this game, though, I reckon. So why don't we have a buddy bet on this? All thanks to Buddy Bet, our handshake hero, is thanks to them. Download the Buddy Bet app now and gamble responsibly.
I'll let you go first. Who do you like?
I will tip an upset. I'll say Ballarat to win this first final.
No.
Grandfather played for him, so I'm going to go for him.
Okay, well, I'm not. I'm going to go for Melton. I think Melton will win. They've been the best team all year. So I'm going for Melton.
What are we having on it?
Well, it's a Ballarat footy league. Let's, what about a pair of thermals?
Well, it's always about 10 degrees colder in Ballarat. Well, so, yeah, we'll have a pair of thermals.
The winner of the bet
gets a pair of
thermals.
And a hot chocolate.
It's harsh on the Ballarat. It's actually a beautiful town, but it does get a fraction chilly.
That was our handshake hero. All thanks to Buddy Bet. Download the app now. Start betting against your buddies. Gamble responsibly. Good luck to everybody playing their finals or finishing out their season. Pickers, thank you.
Thank you, Sammy. I'll see you next week, my friend. No more Bendigo talk.
And we'll see you next week on Off the Bench.